My name is Andrea Furlan, and I am a pain specialist in Toronto, Canada. Today we're going to talk about neuropathic pain. With my experience of 25 years working in pain clinics and with patients who have chronic pain, I can say that the worst descriptions that I hear about pain and chronic pain are from patients who have neuropathic pain. I remember a patient who had had a stroke, and he described his pain as burning oil on all the left side of his body, burning oil constantly dripping on all of his left side of his body. I also remembered a patient who had diabetic neuropathy, and the way he described his pain was like ants crawling his legs all day long, constantly, and he could not do anything for those ants to go away. A very well-known painter, Frida Kahlo, she had neuropathic pain, and she painted her pain. And if we see one of her paintings, this is called The Broken Column. It's a self-portrait from 1944. We see that she painted her spine has a metal rod. She also painted her torso has been in a metal corset, always squishing her back and her abdomen. And she also painted some pins and needles all over her skin, and that was constantly causing this tingling in her skin. So how do we define neuropathic pain? Neuropathic pain is defined as pain that is caused by a disease or injury of the nervous system. And we know that the nervous system is composed of a peripheral and a central nervous system. The peripheral nervous system is formed by the nerves, the peripheral nerves, and the central nervous system is basically the spinal cord and the brain. So neuropathic pain can originate from the peripheral nervous system or the central nervous system. The examples of some of the peripheral neuropathies that can cause neuropathic pain are diabetic neuralgia, postherpetic neuralgia, trigeminal neuralgia, carpal tunnel syndrome, HIV neuropathy, and alcoholic neuropathy. The central neuropathies can be things caused by stroke, like a central post-stroke pain or after brain injury, multiple sclerosis, spinal cord injury. Those are some examples of central neuropathic pain. We know that neuropathic affects 8% of the general population. And how do we make the diagnosis of neuropathic pain? So basically, the diagnosis is by examining the patient and talking to the patient, and we call this signs and symptoms. So some of the symptoms that the patients will complain, that they will tell us about pain, the pain descriptors are very characteristic of neuropathic pain. These are usually, they describe as tingling. Tingling is like pins, needles, pricking. Like the patient that I mentioned to you that described to me the ants crawling in her in his skin, that's what we call tingling. Patients will also refer the pain as hot or burning. They may also describe as shooting pain or electrical shocks, or they may talk about stabbing or cutting, like a knife entering the skin. Those are the descriptors of pain. Other sensations also that are common and related to the neuropathic pain can be numbness or lack of sensation in an area of the body. Also, they may describe that touching that area is painful. So normally, if we touch someone, it doesn't cause pain. But when that happens, we call that allodynia. Also, they may describe intolerance to cold, to extreme cold. They can't tolerate cold. Applied cold to the skin or even cold weather. When we examine the patient, we are looking for signs in the physical exam that will identify some neuropathy, and these are typical signs in neuropathic pain. So for example, reduced sensations. If we examine the patients and they have reduced sensation to pain, we call that hypoalgesia, but they may also have reduced sensations. They may not feel pressure, heat, cold, touch. We call that hypoesthesia. Or there might be augmented, elevated sensations. They may feel more. We call that hyperesthesia and hyperalgesia. Or there might be cross sensations. We may touch the skin with a stimulus that causes touch, and the patient may say, "This is pain." So that's a cross sensation, and we call that allodynia. We may also examine the rest of the nerve system. We need to examine for the reflexes, the motor strength, to see if we can identify what is the underlying neurological condition that is causing that neuropathic pain. And I have to say that in many cases, we can't find what is causing the neuropathic pain. And those are the difficult cases, because if it's not diabetes, if it's not postherpetic neuralgia, then it's hard even for us to treat. But in many cases, we can find a cause for the neuropathic pain. In other cases, we may also order other tests like skin biopsy, nerve biopsy, or electromyography and nerve conduction studies. So how do we treat neuropathic pain? We use a variety of modalities, pharmacological, non-pharmacological. We are going to talk a little bit about those. In terms of drugs or pharmacological, we may use antidepressants like the tricyclic antidepressants or the SNRIs like duloxetine, venlafaxine. We may also use anticonvulsants like carbamazepine, gabapentin, pregabalin. We may also use opioids like tramadol or stronger opioids. We may also use cannabinoids. And other things that we can also prescribe are things like vitamins, especially vitamin B. We can also use the known drugs like physical modalities, such as what my patient found, the warm water. We can prescribe them like warm baths or TENS machines, which is some electrical stimulation to the skin. We can also prescribe topical creams, things like capsaicin or lidocaine or ketamine creams. We can also do some injections, botulinum toxin type A or nerve blocks. And also complementary and alternative medicine, things like acupuncture, manipulation, they work well for some types of neuropathic pain, especially peripheral nerves like carpal tunnel syndrome. Other things are mind-body therapy, like CBT, hypnosis, mindfulness. Those things are very helpful. When we see a patient with neuropathic pain, we have to tell them there are many modalities, not only medications, that can help with your neuropathic pain, and you have to put them in a toolbox. Remember the toolbox for treatment of chronic pain. And you may have seen that exercises is not in this toolbox of treatment of neuropathic pain. It's not because I forgot it. It's because exercise is usually not very helpful to treat the neuropathic pain, although we tell people to continue doing exercises, has tolerated any kind of exercise that they like, to maintain their body in shape and also to avoid other types of pain, which can be myofascial pain that could aggravate the neuropathic pain. Our first goal when we see someone with neuropathic pain is to ask how they are sleeping, and we try to help their sleep. And we try to do this with medications or relaxation or mindfulness, because people with neuropathic pain, is very common that they can't sleep well, and if they can't sleep well, they're always more stressed. They may gain weight, they're more anxious, more depressed. So we need to tackle the sleep problem right away. And I like to mention also that there are some types of neuropathic pain that can be prevented. Things like vaccines for varicella zoster, or reducing alcohol intake to avoid alcoholic neuropathy. Controlling the blood sugars in people who have diabetes is also a good idea. And things like wearing helmets to avoid brain injury, because I see some patients who had neuropathic pain because of a traumatic brain injury. Remember that this video is not intended to provide individual medical advice. If you think that you have neuropathic pain and you need medical treatment, please consult your physician to get a treatment plan for you. This video is only for educational purposes. And if you like this video, don't forget to like it, to write your comments, write your questions, and I will prepare more videos in the future to answer your questions. I also have a Twitch, an Instagram account, and a Facebook page. You can also contact me there. Thank you for watching. Bye.